share with you what it means to learn Torah b'shat adachak, when it's hard, when it's very, very hard. Mike, you with me? This midrash that I'm about to read, right, is the midrash Rabbah in Parsha Pekudei. I show in Rabbi Yisrael Salanti, he has a sefer. Rabbi Yisrael Salanti has a sefer Or Yisrael in the Bikochavei Or. In Article 8, he brings down this story, which I'm about to read. But then he asks a fundamental question, an unbelievable question. How could it be that a woman, we'll see, whose wife was able to answer Rebbe? Rebbe was the richest man. He was Rebbe who wrote the Mishnah. He was one of the biggest rabbis. How can she go and answer him the way she did? I want to show you how this goes, just to show you what it means to learn Torah when it's hard versus learning Torah when it's easy. So it says like this, guys. It goes like this. Ma'aseh b'Rabbi Shimon ben Chalafta. There was a story with Rabbi Shimon ben Chalafta. Sheba Erev Shabbat v'lo hayalom me'en litparnes. Came Erev Shabbat, he did not have anything to put on the table. No fish, nothing. Yatza lo chutz min ha'ir. He came outside of the city. V'itpalal lefnei ha'elohim. He went and he downed before Hashem. V'nitan lo even tova min ha'shamayim. Hashem gave him a pearl, a diamond from heaven. Natana l'shuchani. He went, he gave it to one of these money exchanges that people that know about pearls. So he gave an exchange money. Upernes oto Shabbat. He went and he sustained himself with that money that he got Shabbat. He came home on Shabbat. The whole table was full of delicacies. His wife never saw this food before. They were very poor. Rabbi Shimon ben Chalafta, he was the poorest man. Amra ishto, guys, listen to this carefully. Listen what it means. What a wife understands, what it means when a husband learns Torah. What and how it's very important about Olam Haba, what's going to be there. Amra ishto mehechan elu. Rabbi Shimon ben Chalafta, his wife said to him, where'd you get all this food from? What's it? My Mishnah Halal said, why all this food today? Where'd you get all the money from? We don't have money. Amar la mimashi pernesa kadosh baruch hu. He answered her, Hashem gave me the money. Hashem gave me this money. Amra im en ata omer li mehechan hen, eni to'emet klum. Eshet chal, rabotai. His wife said, if you're not going to tell me where you got this money, how you were able to afford all these delicacies, I'm not eating anything on Shabbat. Imagine, on Shabbat itself, on Shabbat, I'm not tasting nothing until you tell me where you got the money from. Hidchil misaperla, he began to tell the story. Amar la, kach nitpalalti lefna Elohim v'nitan li min ha'shamayim. He said, I went, I downed before Hashem, and he gave it to me, min ha'shamayim. He gave me this pearl. Amra lo, listen to this, rabotai, listen what we're missing. She said to him, eini to'emet klum ad she'tomar li she'tachzira mochi Shabbat. I'm not tasting anything on Shabbat until you're going to tell me, you're going to promise me that you're going to return everything back mochi Shabbat. I want to say, I don't want to see nothing here.
Why? Wait for it.
Amar la, lama. Rabbi Shimon ben Chalafta said, why? What happened? I don't understand. Hashem gave it to me. You wanted, you were complaining. Here you go. He said, Amar lo, she said to him, Atar rotze, rabotai, listen to this. Atar rotze shiyeh shulchonecha chaser. You want your table to be lacking in the next world? If each table has four legs, your table is going to have three legs. Every other tzaddik is going to have four legs, your table is going to have three legs. Look what a woman understands, what it means. Olam Haba. She doesn't allow her husband to waste her life on vanities and everything else. Vishulchan chaverecha male. Your table will be lacking. Their table, your friend's tables will be full. V'halach Rabbi Shimon Hodi ma'aseh l'Rebbe. Rabbi Shimon ben Chalafta, he was a Talmud of Rebbe. You know what he said? No, it doesn't work like this. I have to ask Rebbe, who was the richest man in the world. He was a billionaire. I have to go ask him what he says. Women don't make p'sak halacha. The Rebbe is going to make p'sak. My Rabbi is going to make p'sak halacha. Amar lo lech emor la im shulchanech chaser ani am le'enu mishali. You ready for this? Rabbi Shimon ben Chalafta, when he told the story to Rebbe, you know where Rebbe answered him? He said, Rabbi Shimon ben Chalafta, go tell your wife, after 120, if you're going to be lacking anything on your table, I will fill it in. You could take from my zuchuyot, my mitzvot. I have a lot of them. I'll give it to you. Don't worry. Halach ve'amarla, he went and she told him. He went and he told her. Amru lo, rabotai, listen what the wife said. Look how she answered him. Amru lo, lech imi. She said to him, come with me. Torah. Let's go. The wife told Rabbi Shimon ben Chalafta, come with me to the rabbi that teaches you Torah. I want to see what kind of Torah he's teaching you. Huh? This is the wife. Huh? Amro lo, she said to him, Rabbi, v'chi ro'eh adam l'chaver l'olam haba? Rabbi, what? In olam haba, what? His friend, another friend, is going to be able to see another friend that you said you're going to fill up his table? What kind of talk is this? Local tzaddik, tzaddik. Isn't it true that every single tzaddik has his own world? Shenimar, like the pasuk says, Ki holech adam el beit olomo. When a person goes to the next world, v'savu bashuk haspadim, the mourners, the one that eulogized, they walk in the streets, speak about him. But the person that died, he went to the next world. Look what Rabbi said. So the Midrash says, olamim en kitiv el olomo. It doesn't say world. It says his world. Pshat. When Rebbe heard this, that in the next world, that another tzaddik is not able to see another tzaddik, meaning everybody gets his own world, Rebbe retracted. He said, no, something, you're right. You're right, I can't do this. But listen to this carefully. Rabbi Salanta asks, let me ask you a question. How was the wife of Rabbi Shimon ben Chalafta able to have, I don't want to say the chuspah, but how was she able to go and tell Rebbe this statement? What, you don't trust the rabbis? You don't trust what the rabbi told you? If the rabbi tells you your right hand is left, you trust him. Your left hand is right, you trust him. So why over here did she question the rabbi, Chas v'Shalom? So Rabbi Shah Salanti says like this. He brings Perik Avot, Mishnah Hei, Perik Hei, Mishnah Chavav. He says, Ben Hei Hei says, Ben Hei Hei, that's his name. The son of Hei Hei says, Lefum Ta'ara Agro. You guys are ready for this? According to the pain is the gain. What does that have to do with Rebbe? Because since Rebbe was a billionaire and Rabbi Shimon ben Chalafta was poor, his learning Torah with dire, with difficulty, with poverty, it is not exactly the same way when Rebbe was learning his Torah. That's why Rebbe retracted back. That's why Rebbe said, I hear what you're saying. Because I won't be able to transfer him my zichuyot. You know why? His merits. Rebbe said, I'm not going to be able to transfer my merits to him. Why? Because his merits might be even greater than mine. You know why? Because if everything's according to the pain is the gain, I'll put it to you in simple terms. A person comes to learn Torah at night. He wakes up in the morning and it's hard for him. You have to understand that this is the klal. Or a person has to put on tefillin. You have a shul. People come on Shabbat. Hundreds of people, everybody puts on tefillin. Not on Shabbat, on a regular day. Everybody puts on tefillin. Or people come and they keep Shabbat easily without any problem. But you have certain people that they can't put on tefillin. It's hard for them. And they have to break themselves. Or people can't keep the Shabbat. They can't close their business. But they break themselves. You ready for this? According to the pain is the gain. This person that's able to close the store, or this person that's able to put on tefillin, his reward is greater than all the people sitting there. Why? Because for you and me, it's easy. For him, it's hard. The suffering is what's going to bring you the reward. Why am I saying this? From over here, you see a very important concept. That a wife has to know what it means the next world. What it means when her husband sits at home like a couch potato. Make sure your husband is not at home. This is your world. In this world, they don't have peace. In the next world, they're also not going to have peace. At least let them gain something. Believe me, when you learn Torah, you'll have peace in this world also. It's very, very critical. The wife should encourage her husbands to go out and learn Torah. It's hard. I know it's hard. But do you know something? According to the pain is the gain. In the next world, because when a woman is going to see in the next world, Hashem is going to say, you know, Reuven and Sarah, this is your house, the chicken coop. What happened? But Shimon and Leah, six worlds, let's say, the wife is going to eat her husband. What's this? Shehad, I know, I would have never seen you. I would never let you be at home. That's a wise woman. She knows what's going to cost her in the next world if she does not allow her husband to learn Torah. Bezrat Hashem, no. You see, Rabbi Shimon, his wife, she could have enjoyed all these pleasures. And this is the problem, Rabotai. I understand the wives want their husbands. Bezrat, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, you're home. 4 days you can't give to Hashem. 4 days, not even full days. 1 hour, 2 hours to Hashem you can't give from learning Torah. You can. Why don't you do it? Rabotai, this is the secret. If you want Olam Haba and you want Olam Hazeh, you want to see your children going the right derech? You know, certain people, I have no problems about people flying to Kivrit Tzadikim. I have no people getting big brothers from big rabbis. Take pictures with big rabbis. I have no problem. You can do whatever you have to do, Rabotai. But there's no greater blessing. Like Masechet Berachot says, there's no greater blessing than learning Torah. Talmud Torah connected kulam. When you sit and learn Torah, you know who blesses you? You know who gives you the cash? Hashem himself. So why are you looking for messengers? I'm not telling you that. Okay, from time to time you can go. But don't waste your life thinking that this bracha is going to help, that bracha is going to help. The only bracha that's going to help is learning Torah. Baruch Adonai Olam. Amen.